welcome to our second Composer's Concert of the semester at Stony Brook University. We're thrilled that you've joined us to share the recent work of great composers in the music department. Of course, we wish we could be together in the Stoller Center. However, this online medium has offered us a new and exciting vantage point to view our art form. Feel free to use the chat after the performances, and we hope you enjoy the concert. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Kevin Kay, and my piece is called DXDT. DX over DT is a mathematical shorthand that describes an object's change in position, DX, over change in time, DT. This is shown quite literally in the notation of the piece, where each player's finger placement on the instrument is shown on a vertical axis, and time is represented on a horizontal axis. This piece can be performed by four violins, or four violas, or four cellos, or four double basses. This is because it uses a tuning system that can be transposed onto each new set of four instruments. The tuning system used is called Pythagorean tuning, and for those that want a deeper dive into what that entails, here it is. So Pythagorean tuning is a tuning system that uses only naturally tuned perfect fifths. So string players already do this, such as a violin player tuning their instrument to G, D, A, and E. What they naturally count for in playing, though, is that a natural perfect fifth is actually about 2 cents sharp. For reference, the distance between one chromatic note and its neighbor is 100 cents. This becomes interesting when we keep stacking fifths on top of each other. So let's go through this. If we start on a G and tune up, we get a D that's 2 cents sharp. Now this is hardly perceptible. If we tune a fifth up from that D, we get an A that's now 4 cents sharp. Again, not super noticeable. However, if we keep going through the circle of fifths, we will eventually reach back to G. Now this G will be a whopping 24 cents sharp compared to the G we started with, which is quite noticeable. So the way this functions in this piece is that a stack of 12 perfect fifths is sort of mapped on to the open strings of the ensemble. In other words, each string player retunes its strings such that all of the strings of the ensemble combined will account for all 12 notes of the chromatic scale, each note with a respective cent deviation that I just discussed. This piece utilizes only open strings and harmonics, providing what I find to be quite a vibrant and resonant atmosphere. The version you will hear was recorded multi-track by the incredible violinist Austin Welleman. Austin is a virtuosic soloist in his own right, and he also plays with the Jack Quartet. I hope you enjoy this piece, and thanks for tuning into the concert. Thank you.
Thank you. My name is John Ling, and I'm the composer of the next piece on our concert. The piece is called Yes, I Live Inside the Piano. It takes its title from a poem by Katerina Rodchenkova, translated by Alexandra Buchler. I'll now read you the poem. Yes, I live inside the piano. But there is no need for you to come and visit me. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us, and congratulations to all the composers that presented their great work here tonight. We'd especially like to thank all of the performers that continually foster a great collaborative environment here at the university. We hope to see you soon. Our next composer's concert is Wednesday, December 2nd at 7:30 p.m. Thank you and have a great night.